Hi, everybody. I got a couple questions tonight about how to complete your final project if you no longer have access to the GIS software or to a computer. Now, if you do have access to a computer but you don't have a code for the software, let me know. If you have a tablet, this should work. It'll be a little bit, it's going to be a lot more difficult on your phone, but I've seen crazier things happen. So let's start with the example if you have a computer but you don't have the software for whatever reason. First thing to do is let me know that you would like access to our ArcGIS Online organizational account. That will give you some extended features of our with ArcGIS Online. The second thing you would do is download the data from SanGIS like you would in the past, like you have in the past. So you can download that zip data. That's all you need. If I want that San Diego Parks, I can just download that one. And we want to keep it in that zipped folder. So unlike when you're working in ArcGIS desktop, here we're going to keep it in the zipped folder and not touch it. If you're trying to bring your files from your project onto ArcGIS Online, you do want to make sure everything gets zipped together. So this shapefile for the San Diego Parks has eight individual files associated with it. So we want all of that to go together to be zipped up. So back in ArcGIS Online, we'll just click Add Item from your computer, choose our file. And we can add in some tags. And then you'll click Add Item. And I'm going to go ahead and pause this video because it takes a minute or two to upload. Okay, so we can see that my layer has added, I'm sorry, my shapefile has added now as a feature layer to ArcGIS Online, and it's still loading. But in a second, we'll see that we have the option to open it in the map viewer. There we go. We can do things like add a brief summary, but sometimes the SanGIS data pops up by itself. Yeah, it already has that metadata associated with it, so it gets a little summary for you. We can go ahead and click on Open in Map Viewer. And it will add to our map. Now, you may be thinking, well, I can't. Oh, let's just do this real quick. That's fine. Okay. You might be thinking, let's remove some of these files in here that are from my previous version of this video. Just pretend you're not seeing this. Okay, so you should just have your one file in there. Let's say that you haven't downloaded the data yet and you no longer have the ability to. Well, that's okay because in ArcGIS Online, SanDag or SanGIS has a lot of that data on ArcGIS Online, or at least some of it. So you can go to Add and search for layers. Now, this is where if I wanted to add in that Parks layer, I could just add it directly from here, but I already have it in. We can also change from My Content to ArcGIS Online. And then we can type in things like, let's say, San Diego Transit. And we'll see we have a couple files pop up. And if you see these files that have this RISB, these are the ones that are done by San Diego, by SanGIS and SanDag. So we can go ahead and click on the stops and add them in. We can go ahead and go back. And we can see that legend of what these data are. So you can see a lot of the bus stops in the red and coaster, sprinter, other things in other colors. Now, in our organizational account for ArcGIS, you will have a couple more options for analysis that you can do. So once you get into our organizational account, you can click on Perform Analysis, and you'll see there are a lot of tools here for you. Now, these, as you start going through them, you'll see that there are buffers, there are dissolve, merge, overlay, extract data, find locations, find cylinder locations, find a centroid. aggregate points, which is spatial join, join features, summarize. So there's a lot of things here for you to use. Some of them we haven't used yet in ArcMap, but the basic ones that you're interested in are in here. So let's just say we wanted to know, our research question was, which parks in the city of San Diego are best served by public transit? So we want to know, just not in the county, but just in the city, sorry, which parks have the most options for transit within their borders. We could buffer the polygons if we wanted to. Sorry, we could buffer and say within a quarter mile of parks, but for the simplicity of this video, we're just going to aggregate the points. So this would be your spatial join. We are going to stick with joining. Let me go back. For your spatial join, you do have to click on the point layer that you're joining to your geographies, which is our polygons, which are our parks. So if you just click in the analysis tab, you should be able to go ahead and do the aggregate points. But if you are clicking, like if you click down here on the parks and go to perform analysis, it won't let you do that analysis. So let's go back and just hit analysis. And we're going to summarize data, aggregate points. So we got our the layer containing points to aggregate. We're going to stick with the areas of our parks. Keep the areas with no points. We're not going to mess around with statistics in this example to save time. I can say spatial join transit. And we'll just stick with, I'm going to uncheck that because I don't know if there's any parts of the city that are outside of my current view. So we'll just go ahead and click run analysis. This will take a minute again, so I'm just going to go ahead. You can see it's starting up here. I'm just going to pause. Alrighty, so we can see that we have our spatial join of our transit join to parks. So let's look at the symbols. We're looking at the count of points. We could do graduated colors, probably our best bet, or you could do counts and amounts with the size. But we'll do size with color. That doesn't look good. Hang on. Okay, I switched to the count amounts, and I just need to change the color now because it's in blue on blue, or excuse me, orange on orange. So I'm just gonna make it a blue really quickly. Sorry. So we don't, so anyway, we're just going to pretend that, so we can see now that we have our, why does it do that? Okay, this makes more sense. Now we're understanding it. So we can start to see we have our perks in green. Maybe not the best green, but you can mess around with that later. We can turn off all the transit stops, and we can start to see where transit stops are intersecting with the data. The problem that we're having is that this is showing the count of points and having a zero value. So we're seeing a lot of zeros. For these parks that don't have any, you can actually see. Yes, this is a cemetery, and it's telling you that. Let's see. It's telling us that it has less than zero or zero points in it. So it's a bit confusing how this is displaying. Gosh, I kind of want to redo this, but I'm going to stick with it for now. But you can see, you could mess around more with the symbology. And oh wait, I think it did it. So I just clicked on the default style. That's how I did it. I clicked on the default style, and sometimes it works well. So now we can see. All right, we did it. Ah, shoot, cancel. We want to see this. We can see. So I clicked on default style, and everything got fixed beautifully. But you can see with all the perks, you could see the number of the transit stops within them. So then you could look at the entire area and figure out which perks are the best served, which perks are the least served. Like this one doesn't have any. So this is Sycamore Canyon open space area. Doesn't have any. What about, let's look at, where is it? Here we go. Cows Mountain and Mission Trails. So you can see there aren't actually any transit stops really close to Mission Trails. We could, like I said, we could have done a buffer beforehand, and maybe there are some on the outside. See, they're not that close to some of the main trail lists. But anyway, you could do some investigating of your data that way. So that's one way, two different ways to add your data in and how to symbolize it, and a long exposition of me trying to figure out how to symbolize it.